Hello, I'm Ram Gopal from presentationprocess.com. In this edition of PowerPoint Diagrams tutorial series, you will learn how to create 3D battery infographic in PowerPoint. The infographic you will learn to create looks like this. Isn't this beautiful? Let us see how to create this beautiful diagram from scratch by going to a new slide. You can of course go to a new slide by clicking on this particular button here, which says new slide. Alright, if you observe closely, this infographic diagram is made of three components. They are this one, which is a 3D cylinder which forms the outer part. This one, which is a 3D cylinder again, which forms the inner part, which shows the portion to which the cylinder is filled, which represents percentage of charge in a battery, and this one, which represents the cap of a battery. So all three are nothing but 3D cylinders of different sizes and different material and lighting. You will understand this a little more once we go to create the diagram from scratch. First, let us create the outer cover. For this, I am going to use this tool called as Oval Tool under Basic Shapes in Auto Shapes menu. And when I click on that particular tool and hold the Shift tab and drag the corner, I get a circle. Now, right click, go to Format Shape. If you are using PowerPoint 2007 or 2010, you will have a dialog box pop up, but in 2013 you will have a separate pane where you have all the controls. I am going to use the effects option here, and the first thing I am going to do is to use 3D rotation. The 3D rotation I am going to use is this one called as perspective relaxed, and I am going to increase the Y rotation, rather reduce. So this is the portion, so you reduce the Y rotation to get this angle. So this seems to be good, which is 294.6 degrees as the Y rotation angle. We don't want the outline, so I'm going to remove the shape outline, and I'm going to use some bevels which are under 3D format option. The top bevel I'm going to use is called as circle. So click on it. Now as soon as I click on it, you can see some very nice bevel effect created to our 3D circle. Now I am going to increase the depth to 200 points. Now this is the outer cover, and if you are not happy with the angle, once you see this depth you will be able to make a judgment. You can always move it down a little bit more, like this one, say 284.6 is a good enough angle for our Y rotation. The next thing we are going to do is to change the shape fill color. I am going to use a lighter gray color, and I am also going to do one more thing, which is I am going to increase the transparency to say 40%. The reason why we want the transparency increased is so that we can have another of these 3D cylinders of a different color placed behind it, and that will show through as though you are able to see through a glass cylinder. If you are not happy with the fill color, maybe you can go in for slightly darker fill color, and this looks good enough. Now I am going to make a copy of this, so as I click on this I also press Ctrl D, and here I have a copy. I want to represent 50% fill for the battery, so instead of having a depth of 200 points in 3D format, I am going to use 100 points as depth. Now I am going to place this here on top of it, so one is above the other or over the other, and I am going to change the material. Instead of the default one, I am going to change the standard, the material as standard matte, and I am going to use the lighting as neutral flood. Now when I change the fill color to green color and go back to the fill option and reduce the transparency, once again go back to 3D format and remove the bevel, you have this beautiful fill effect for the battery diagram. You can choose to have this in the front, or you can send it back so that the effect is that much more realistic. And here we have the basic battery diagram, and all that is left to do is to add a small cap. Now once again let me go to Auto Shapes menu, and under basic shapes I click on the oval tool, and I am drawing a smaller circle this time, and do exactly the same as what we have done earlier, which is go to effects option, go to 3D rotation and use this perspective relaxed, and maybe we will do this, so 284.6, and we are going to increase the depth, maybe this time 25 points, no that is too much, say 10 is good enough. And let me add the top bevel as circle. Now that we have added circle, it adds another 6 points which we don't really want, so maybe I'll have 5 here, so this is good enough. Now I'll keep it on top of this and adjust it slightly using arrows, and maybe I can use a black color and no outline to complete the battery diagram. Isn't this beautiful? Now that I have used this as 50%, the depth is 100 points and this one is 200 points, you can always vary the fill by changing the depth levels. So that is how you create the battery diagram. You can of course add your own text saying 50% and place it on top of this, increase the font size, make it bold. If you want to use Arial black, you can use, and maybe you can change the font color to white to complete the diagram. You can also add the shadow. What I'm going to do is to copy the same shadow from the previous example, and I'm going to stick it here and send it back to complete the diagram. So that is how we create the 3D battery diagram. Now this is a way to create editable infographic. What if you could create some stunning infographics like this but are data driven? You have such beautiful diagrams, data driven infographics available in our Visual PowerPoint Graphs pack, and this is one such example. Here you can see that the battery diagram looks stunning. Now to add to it, this is totally data driven. For example, I want to change this from 68% to say 50% or 40%. I have clicked on this. Now as I click here, you can see that these options for changing the value comes here. So right click and go to edit data. Now as I click on edit data, here I have the yellow column where I can change the value. So instead of the 68% here, I am going to say 40%, and as soon as I click 40%, you have 40% the data label here and the fill level changing. So that is how this particular infographic works. If you don't want it vertically, here we have the same battery diagram available horizontally, and once again this is totally data driven. Now I go to edit data, and instead of 54%, maybe 35% is the level, and as you can see here the battery level changes, and this one is a battery charge on a scale of 1 to 10. This is usually used for some of the concept diagrams where you talk about what percentage of project is completed or what is the result on a survey. So that is how this is used, and here each of these rings represents the level of fill. So let me once again go to edit data. Instead of 6, maybe I can use 7, or you will not really see much of a difference here, maybe 3. And as I do that, you can see the number of rings going down to 3 and the number automatically return. These are just a few examples that I've shown from our 320 plus Visual PowerPoint Graphs pack. The pack has more than 320 unbelievably beautiful graphs which are fully editable. They are created by experts. You don't have to have any additional software. Works entirely within PowerPoint. And of course, you can purchase it directly and you will have instant download with 30 days money back. These Visual PowerPoint Graphs pack graphs are created for busy business presenters like you. All you need to do to visualize your data is to pick up a graph that represents your idea correctly, and then you just replace the sample data with your own data to complete the diagram or to complete the infographic. Hope you liked our tutorial on creating 3D battery infographic in PowerPoint. If you want to learn more such tutorials, if you want to read more articles, or if you want to watch more videos like this, please visit us at presentationprocess.com. Thanks a lot for watching the video and happy presenting.